Well, g'day, good afternoon, maybe good morning, maybe good, well, whatever it is. Greetings and welcome to Sunday Night Music on Australian Radio Indy. No matter where you are in the world, thanks for tuning in and listening to us from, well, it's a great day here on the Central Coast of New South Wales. That's right, it's Dingo, and look who I've got here with me.
It's Jonesy. How are you, my friend?
I'm good, isn't it? Hasn't it been great weather? This is really nice. I'm enjoying. I know people don't understand. We're just entering spring, and the rest, well, the people in the northern hemisphere, they're entering fall or autumn. We call it autumn here.
It's best time of the year, I reckon.
Well, I've just been looking at your garden. You've been busy out in the garden planting all the plants. I've planted some plants myself, so we'll just see what happens.
Not the special plants, I hope.
No, not the special plants. Just some tomatoes.
I got a friend growing special tomatoes, but he's up the north coast.
They're really tasty.
But anyway.
Oh well, I was just saying before I planted some tomatillos. They're your Mexican tomato.
Well, I'll be fascinated to see how they go.
Well, they're a really funny little tomato, and they've got like a papery husk over it. So I'll have to bring you over some tomatillos once they start growing.
And you discovered these where and when?
I know it sounds dumb. In a Walmart, right?
Walmart. I love Walmart. Hey, I got this vest, this lovely warm vest in a Walmart.
I just love Walmart. So I was just wandering around in a Walmart and you go, what are these? And you pick them up because initially I don't know what a tomatillo is. I mean, it says tomatillo. And it's like a green tomato with a paper, like a tomato in a paper bag, if that makes sense.
Wow. There you go. Well, I'll have to try one, mate. When your crop is ready to harvest, you'll have to invite me over and we'll taste test.
we could do a tomato versus tomatillo taste test. Now, we're probably going to be into trouble anyway, because if we've got people watching in the US, you say tomato, we say tomato.
Yeah, and we're like talking to our mates in the States. Oh, and do a shout-out to Tony and Tim from What's Happening Entertainment Radio. And, yeah, it was through chatting with Tim and seeing what they do, I've decided let's combine our forces, and he's going to join us and we're going to join him. And he's going to do a radio program for us, and we're doing radio programs for him. So it's going to be a good little collaboration between What's Happening Entertainment and Australian Radio Indy.
Oh, that sounds like a lot of pressure on us, Jonesy.
It's never pressure, mate, never pressure.
And it'll all be fun and entertainment.
That is, and it's all about the music. Have you got any music news for this week, or what have you been up to musically this week? Or is the COVID been keeping
us? Well, the COVID hit. I was meant to be, I wouldn't have been in the US at the moment, but I would have been in the US in May, June. And unfortunately, the COVID put an end to that. But we were talking music before, and I guess, who was I going to see this time? We're going to see Jimmy Buffett.
Oh, yeah, wow.
We were going to see Kenny Chesney, yep. And I was off to Rock the South. And if you're looking for a great concert to go to and you haven't been to Rock the South, it is just an absolute fantastic festival. But talking about Kenny Chesney and Jimmy Buffett, you go, okay, both ends of the spectrum.
Yep.
But I'm about to surprise you with a link, because when I was in the US last year, I saw Kenny Chesney in Des Moines, Iowa. Why would you go to Iowa? Well, because you know what? The tickets were cheap. We drove a day and a half to get there, but the tickets were cheap. And it was a great venue, because that's the beauty of American concerts.
Yeah.
They don't have to cram a stadium, because you know what? Sometimes the artists just move on to the next big town. So we're seeing Kenny Chesney, and the opening act is someone I hadn't heard of, and I'm sitting there and going, wow, how fantastic is this singer? So I actually got my little notebook out and wrote down and thought, yep, I will check up on that person. So I checked up. The lady's name was Caroline Jones.
Must be good with a name like that.
Yeah, she related to you. I didn't even do that link, Jonesy, until just now. Anyway, Caroline Jones, and I'm thinking, oh, the chances of probably hearing from her, seeing her again, you know, she's a great artist.
Yeah.
But and if she's touring with Kenny Chesney, you go, that's fantastic. So I then have a listen to some more of her music. And then the next thing I hear about Caroline Jones is one of our local, I guess, media organisations sends me a media release to say they've just signed up Caroline Jones. And I go, well, so I know more about Caroline Jones. So Caroline, American dad, Australian mum. Yep. So that's how she makes it into Australian radio indie.
Yep.
And so she performed with, let me just reach for my notes. I know I may be a bit cheating.
Look, he's organised. I waffle, but he's got the facts and figures.
Yeah, so she's toured with the Eagles, Zach Brown, Tim McGraw, Faith Hill, Kip Moore, Vince Gill, Kenny Chesney, that's where I saw her, and Jimmy Buffett.
Wow.
And guess what she's done? She's done a duet with Jimmy Buffett.
Wow. Wow.
So she's got an album out there, but she's just released an EP, and the latest one is a song, a duet with Jimmy Buffett. So there you go, just from a talk about Walmart, going to see
connecting the dots there, my friend.
Kenny Chesney, he puts on a great performance.
Yeah.
And, you then go, just from writing a name down in a little notebook, you then find that, she's releasing a duet with Jimmy Buffett.
Wow. And are we going to play one of her songs today?
Yeah, I've got a couple of her songs here, so we can put those in. And, particularly the Jimmy Buffett song. But you just go, that's someone I think we're going to have to keep an eye on, because particularly with, living in the US, having the Australian connection.
So she'd have a dual passport, I'd say.
I would say so. So you just never know where she's going to pop up.
Yeah.
But I guess once this COVID is lifted, then I guess she'll be out touring again, and you never know who she's going to be supporting. So I'd be checking her out, Caroline Jones, and, check out Caroline.
Have we got any social media links? I'll put them in the description on the YouTube or the social media pages when we advertise the show.
She will.
I'll whack them up on the screen, actually.
Whack them up on the screen. Check her out on your music streaming service, Caroline Jones.
Yep, good on you, mate. And that's what we'll do. We'll have a listen to one of her songs. You can pick it. Which one?
I think we started off with the Jimmy Buffett link. So let's go with...
And is this coming out through Social Family?
This is,
Social Family Records?
Social Family Records.
Well, that's one of our bigger, one of our small independent labels, but geez, they've got some great artists, especially country. They're attacking that market at the moment.
Yeah, they have so many great artists, and I know it sounds like a play on Social Family, but they really are. Really are a group of great people who get on.
I remember I got invited down to a Christmas party a few years ago now through Social Family Records, and it was to go see a heavy rock band called The Dead Daisies, and they were played on the rooftop of the Triple M down in Sydney. Oh, man, that was a what an awesome super group they were at the time. And Social Family Records at the time was their label. I'm not too sure if they're still with them now, but this was a few years back. But they had John Stevens as their vocalist. Richard Fortus, the guitarist from Guns N' Roses, he was their lead guitarist. Marco Mendoza from Whitesnake and a few other big bands, he was the bass player. Who else? Brian Tichy on drums. Man, what a drummer that dude is. And I'm a bit of a drum aficionado. I just love watching quality drummers play. But, yeah, let's enough chatting about them. Great people, Social Family Records. And I'm sure we'll try to work with them a bit. Let's see if we can get a connection.
Well, they just have so many great artists, and they're just keeping everybody informed about what they're doing.
All right. So we're going to hear Caroline Jones. You can introduce it right now.
Okay, coming up here, well, let's just have a look. So Wigger will play Gulf Coast Girl, and so it was written by Jimmy Buffett and McAnally, and features Jimmy Buffett, McAnally, Kenny Chesney, and Lucas Nelson, and obviously Caroline Jones. Take it away, Jonesy.
And here it is.
Like to splash in the waves, baby, misbehave occasionally. I spend a fair amount of time at the floor, Bama line, destined to hang out more in Mobile and Gulf Shores. A very special charts locked in my heart, a places that I love to be. Cause I'm a Gulf Coast girl, partial to the warm winds and the salty water.
On the beach in Biloxi,
get tanner, get thinner, and go home a winner occasionally.
We can surf Boca Chica and Galveston Bay, ride horses on the beach in South Padre.
No, we're not in Kansas. Hola, Porter Andrews, do you want a two-step with me? Cause I'm a Gulf Coast girl, partial to the warm winds and the salty water.
Streaming Australian music on the World Wide Web.
Oh, listen to the crowd.
Yeah, there you go. Caroline Jones.
Caroline Jones and Jimmy Buffett and Kenny Chesney and others, and a great song about being a Gulf Coast girl. And if you're wondering where the Gulf Coast is, that's not Gold Coast for the Australian listeners. That's Gulf Coast, and that's not where you play golf. No. It's Gulf Coast as in...
As in the, not the Gulf of Carpentaria.
No, the Gulf of Mexico way.
The Gulf of Mexico. So, all right, let's just say too... we're good friends from an old FM station where we used to work, and John is specialty, or I should say, I'll cut that out, we'll go Dingo, he's specialty, and Dingo for our American friends. But Dingo's got my baby.
Oh, I'm not allowed to say that, because but a Dingo does have your music, your country music at the moment.
All right, well... Dingo is a country music aficionado. He's we were great friends at a local FM station, and that's where we sort of met. And he's coming on board with us here at Australian Radio Indie. We're really grateful that he's coming on board with his country music, and we're going to do a country music show as well. So apart from our Sunday nights ARI, what are we calling it? The ARI.
Sunday Evening Music Spectacular? Something like, I mean, I think it probably needs to have music and spectacular, because that just makes it sound fantastic.
It does. And we're in collaborations with our good friends over in the States, our mates from the States in, are they Carolina? I think they're Carolina.
There's a North Carolina, yeah. There's South Carolina. Let's just call it the Carolinas. That'll keep them happy.
Yeah, okay. Well, and they're called What's Happening Entertainment. So if you're looking on digital radio for music, you can always come to Australian Radio Indie. And if you want to hear something different, go over and check out What's Happening Entertainment Radio. That's a long way, a lot of words to do.
It is a lot of words.
Yeah, I got told that when I put Australian Radio Indie. They said, why don't you just do ARI?
Oh, because that could be the Australian rabbit.
Incorporation.
Yes. I think Australian Radio Indie.
I think there's, But anyway, we're our good friends over there have motivated us, or motivated me, to get involved, and I've invited my good mate from the old station, Dingo, and we're just playing a few country tunes. We're going to run it for just around an hour. And it's going to be 6 p.m. on radio every Sunday, and a little bit later than that on YouTube as well. So you can see the good-looking bloke, what the Dingo looks like.
Jeez, I'm no oil painting.
No, well, yes, well, they need more oil to paint me.
Now, I know, I mean, we've just been talking about your friends in the US broadcasting from the Carolinas. Perhaps we should tell... So people can look us up on a map. We're broadcasting from the central coast of New South Wales, which is on the east coast of Australia. So if you're looking for, you know, you want to dig out your atlas of the world or Google us, probably Gosford is the biggest spot. Although, you know, just down the road there's the entrance and lots of other places around. But yeah, if you're looking on a map of the world, without having to Google too far in, look for Gosford and you'll have the area that we're
surrounded by glorious beaches, waterways, there's lakes
and bushland
and the mountains as well, and music. What's your thoughts on the Central Coast music scene?
Well, I was just going to say, we're surrounded by beach, mountains, lakes, country music.
Yeah.
Great country music. I mean, there have been lots of artists who have relocated to the Central Coast purely because there are other great artists on the Central Coast. So, you know, we are really, really blessed with the number of artists we have here. And there's some great recording studios, and perhaps at some point in the future we could, interview some of the producers who are on the Central Coast. And there is just some great musos here.
And some great people as well in the music scene.
Yeah,
the music scene is such a like it's got the extremes of the human nature. You've got the really kind-hearted people in the middle ground.
You mean like you and I?
Yeah, that's it, man. The good people. And then like 99% of the people are awesome. And then you've got the 1% or half a percent either side that are either shooting for the stars and nothing's going to stop them. And they, I've met them all. Trust me, I've done this for 7 years and I've met so many great people. But geez, there's a couple that stand out too for one reason or another. And but in saying that, the music and musicians are so critical on their own product. Have you noticed that? Have you?
Oh, what I find is that I guess it brings it back to, why do you listen to music? Well, are you listening for the words or are you listening to the music? But I just like to listen to, well, it can be either. That is, the music that I like has a good story to start with. And I'm just amazed sometimes at how you can cram a story into that 3 minutes, between 3 and 4 minutes. And sometimes it can be a murder mystery and they do that in 3 to 4 minutes. Yes, there are some beautiful ballads out there.
Yep.
But just some great music.
There is, and that's the whole reason that I think I met you as a fan of music, and then
I was a fan of you, Jonesy. Come on, admit it. I used to phone up Jonesy on Sunday night.
You did, actually, but I'll never forget. Where were you overseas 1 year? And
I called. Yeah, I called in. Yeah,
Scandinavia or somewhere.
Oh yeah, I like to travel a lot. So I think I called in.
Yeah, I couldn't believe it.
I think I called in from Paris. So we were just rushing off to get a train to get a plane or something like that. My partner's going, "Come on, we've got to get out of here." Yeah. And I go, "Oh, I've just got a call," and I hooked up to the Wi-Fi, and I think I was talking to. I was talking to Jonesy as I went further and further out of Wi-Fi range. And
it was awesome. Yeah, I thought this bloke is definitely a music tragic nut, great guy, because he. I thought he couldn't be over there, surely, but there he was traveling the world and listening to some great music. And that's basically when you do travel, music is part of your travels all the time.
Music is, I guess, music. Now I used to travel for other reasons.
Yep.
And I might just quickly say, hey, I used to fly kites, and I guess I'm sitting here because it would be the Fest of the Winds this weekend, but COVID has locked that down. So when I stopped traveling for kites, I started traveling for music. Like, and
honestly, kites, outdoors, windy, nice area, space yourself out, because you can't fly a kite next to somebody rubbing shoulders, surely. You got to be spaced out.
No, kite flying is the most fun you can have with one hand. I mean, the other hand, you've got a beer in it, I have well-behaved kites.
Yeah, but what I'm saying is that surely you can be social distance flying a kite. It's not like grocery shopping at the local supermarket where everyone's wall-to-wall.
I think it was the kite flyers, because the kite flyers could be social distance. I think it was the concerns about the crowds because historically they get 40 to 60,000, 80,000 people attending the...
Crikey.
That is the kite festival. And the problem is that how do you... And because it's open area, that is, how do you limit an open area to simply say, well, the first 5,000 people? I mean, at a football stadium, that's easy.
Yeah.
You can simply say, we're going to let 5,000 people in, but...
Through the counters and the turnstiles. Yeah. Anyway, that's enough of kite flying.
It's enough, yeah. So...
Is there any good kite flying YouTube videos to look at for any potential...
Well, actually, they were doing a virtual kite flying weekend.
Wow.
So for those people, if you jump onto the Bondi Pavilion or just search Fest of the Winds Virtual Festival, so people in America would be able to watch that, because this is going to air. Sunday night.
Yep. Well, they're usually 14 hours behind us.
Yeah.
So so we're in a time zone here. We're
the magic of time zone.
Or is that, that's it, that's the one I was looking for.
We are in the time zone.
How do you like that for a voiceover?
No? Yeah, keep working on it, James.
Keep working on it. Yeah, well, no, we're 14 hours in front. Our time zone is Australian Eastern Standard Time at the moment. When's Daylight Savings kick in?
Daylight Saving will kick in 3 weeks' time.
Wow.
The long weekend, the grand final, long weekend.
Bloody football. You know, football, I'm just over it, to be honest. I've never been. I used to play it, and I used to sort of enjoy it, but nah, mate, they're all, you know.
Well, is that because of the team you're following at the moment?
No, not really. No, I've just been over them for a while. Like, even in American football, like, at the moment, they've just kicked off their season, but it's so political now. They just want to wear, badges to say people matter or whatever they want to talk about, but I'm just over that sort of hypocritical millionaires trying to shove down your throat a cause that really, what do they actually do? That, you know, they do nothing. They go crunch a few heads, push a few people over, tackle a few people, and make good money, lucky bastards. But
yeah, and then they end up with bad news.
Yeah, well.
Concussion.
Yeah.
But anyway, let's get back to the music.
Yeah. Well, anyway, that's my rant for the week.
That's Jonesy's rant. Jeez, he's got all the effects there.
I don't know. What else have we got in there? You know, when you
I'll have to get my dingo howl. Yeah, I'll work on it.
Okay. But the best one is when you tell a story.
Any story.
Tell me something. Tell me something I don't know.
Oh.
Quick and sharp.
Quick and sharp.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm more. That's in there. Putting me on the pressure. Well, I guess most of my jokes are spontaneous and may not be broadcastable sometimes. I mean, a lot of my musical.
I want to push that green button.
Okay. You know how, do you ever sing along to songs and make your own songs up? Use your own lyrics?
Yeah.
My word that I tend to get into a lot of songs is underpants, right? Yeah, underpants. You know, you're just singing a song and you're going, you know what that song needs? It needs an underpants word in there.
Underpants.
it just goes with so many, like chance, underpants. Dance, underpants.
Well, there you go for our budding songwriters out there. There's a challenge. You write an underpants song, get it to me, and I'll play it on air.
I think it's Charlie Walsham. I bought a. he the first track on the album. He gets up, goes about his day.
Yep.
Walks out the door, comes back in, and he forgot to put his pants on. So it's about a 10 or 15 second song that kicks off an album.
Yeah.
And I guess it's the closest I've probably come to a song about underpants because he didn't have any pants on. But
I'll tell you what, you know how, talking about underpants, we were touring America. I went over on a tour with Storm Cellar in late January, February this year, 2020, and had a great time over there. And like this bloke rings me from God knows where in what country when I'm on radio. The phone rings and he goes, Are you in America? And I go, yeah, because I was getting, my phone was still ringing with the Australian number. I was still getting calls via different people who had, you know, nothing else better to do than to call me up. We're driving, God knows where, and my phone would ring and people would say, "G'day, Jonesy, how you going, mate?" And I go, well, it's about minus, like it was middle of winter.
It was the middle of winter. Yeah, so
it was snowing in dirt.
Oh, Dallas, man. I flew in from Heathrow to Dallas Fort Worth,
yep.
And
what a huge airport that is, by the way.
Yep, and we landed the next day, and it was a shocking. I mean, they almost didn't. Well, they almost diverted the flight. In fact, we were the last flight in because they closed everything else down, which is a real bother for everybody else who was flying into Dallas and then was going to go on from there. But we were actually staying in Dallas, so we found our little hotel, got up the next morning, and you're going, oh, look at this weather. And I go outside, and it's snowing. Snowing in Dallas in January. And there were some other people who came out too, and he said he was from New York, and he'd lived in Dallas previously, and he came out and said this is the first time that they'd actually seen snow in Dallas. And we had some people from Hawaii that hadn't seen snow at all before. So there we were taking photos of snow at the hotel in Dallas.
Yeah, well, only a few weeks later, I suppose, or a week or so later, the phone rings and it's my good friend here saying, are you actually in Dallas, and we're only an hour or so.
We were traveling because we'd bought some tickets to go see Dwight Yoakam.
Yep.
And but that was in Oklahoma because I guess we had trouble connecting. Even though we're in the same country, I guess. Yeah. So we'd bought some tickets to go see Dwight Yoakam. So we'd actually left Dallas, driven up to Oklahoma, see Dwight Yoakam, and then came back down to catch up with Jonesy and Storm Cellar in Dallas.
Yeah, that was funny too, because the band, it was a big room.
It was a big house.
Six people. That was a great compound house. It was on about 5 acres as well. There was six in the band, two roadies, Dallas roadie, and then me as well. So there's roughly 10 people in the house. The doorbell rings and people says, who's that? And I said, oh, that could be one of my mates coming over to visit. And they go, you've got mates? Yeah, it was quite funny at the time because, you know, how rock stars are. They all think they're really important. It's not just the social media managers and touring managers that have got got people that want to come and visit and say hi. But in saying that, I'll tell you what we'll do. I'm just looking at the clock here. Why don't we chuck on a song? I want to put a video on this time. It is Storm Cellar's song called Crossfire. So have you heard of Den Henrahan?
Yeah.
All right, Den Henrahan, Christina Crofts. She's a slide guitar queen in Sydney. She's been playing some real bluesy.
I love the slide guitar. Yeah. I mean, I think that's... I love an instrument where you can sit down.
Yeah, well, these are the rock ones, mate. They get up and they just give it curry. But Michael Barry from Storm Cellar gives me a call and says, hey, mate, what are you doing this weekend? I say, I can make time for you. What do you got planned? And he says, come down to Everland Studio in Marrickville, wherever it was. It could have been somewhere around Leichhardt, Marrickville, somewhere around there. And anyway, the GPS gets me to this little laneway in the middle of nowhere where you can, that you see in the bus I got to drive around in.
Yeah.
I'm trying to park it in this little laneway. Anyway, I squeeze between a telegraph pole and this little car, got about an inch to spare, park her up, go in, and they say, get your cameras out, mate. I want you to film the boys making this song, and we're going to make a film clip for it. So, I'm in the studio with Christina Crofts and Dan. You know, they're awesome guitar players, and they turned up for the day. Never knew the song, never heard the song played anywhere. They were given the lyrics, a couple of run throughs, and they said, "This is what we want you to do. We want you to put a guitar solo in here." And they both said, "Oh, who's playing what?" And the producer said, "We don't care who plays what. You can jam all you want. Let's just get it done." So they got in the studio, and within an hour, bang, they got this song. And I'm just
that's the talent. I mean, that's the talent I wish I had of fantastic musicians. They just get together, and sometimes they have nothing, and at the end of that hour, they just have a masterpiece.
Yeah, right. And this song is real sort of country rock in your face sort of a song. I love it. It's called Crossfire. It's coming out on the Storm Cellar album. It's going to be called The Salon Project, where they're inviting all their friends in to participate, whether it be a guitarist, a musician, or a singer.
You'll be lead singer, won't you? You're a friend of the Storm Cellar.
Oh, I am definitely a friend of the Storm Cellar, but with a voice like this, I might be able to do a doo-wop or something.
Some albums need a doo-wop, but Storm Cellar don't.
They don't. They definitely don't. They've got the class and the style. So let's hit it. This was Storm Cellar. And by the way, at around the 3 minute, 25 second mark, is a little 2 second shot where Christina Crofts points the finger straight at me, and it looks really good in the film clip, but what she was saying was, get that beep camera out of my face, is what she was saying after about an hour of filming close up. As a musician, they were concentrating, doing their thing. She turns around and hears me going, oh, I'm filming.
That's another skill. I watch. Yeah, the videographers, is that the word?
When you're
at a concert and, you know, not all...
You've got to know the music too. When you know the music.
And you're sitting up there and you're watching, you know, you're that combination between watching somebody on stage and watching the big screen. And, sometimes it's just absolutely fantastic what those videographers do.
When you know the song, especially the guy running the camera split, when you know the song, you can... just hit the right camera at the right time, and it really brings that song. It's like a light show. If you know the song when you're running the lights, you can turn an average light show into something that's spectacular.
I just thought it was good luck sometimes.
No, well, anyway, here we are. This is Storm Cellar, Crossfire.
Looking forward to it.
Like This is Steve, and Australian Radio Indie rocks my house and my neighborhood too.
Hello, Australian Radio Indie.
It's Billy here from Mount Druitt. Can you play some more Australian music?
Billy, that's all we play around here at Australian Radio Indie.
Oh, yeah, right. I haven't listened to the radio for a while now.
ARI.
The crowd loved it again.
Yeah, that's the old lovely... Hey, what's your thoughts on the Rodecaster as well, by the way, the mixing desk that we're using today?
Oh, that's pretty, looking pretty good there, Jonesy. I like it. All the coloured buttons. I love flashing lights and coloured buttons.
Yeah, the beauty of this is that without even having a laptop or anything to connect the recording on, we've got a little card on the inside there, and we can just take this, plug it in, plug your mics in, talk to anyone anywhere, record it on the card, and away you go. So we can be mobile, we can do a radio program. If anyone out there would like us to specialize in your event or your business, your music, anyone, just hit us up and I'm sure we can work something out, can't we?
I'm sure. Now, I hope everybody watched to the end.
Sure they did. Read
the storm cellar.
Read the credits.
The credits, because Jonesy was on the camera. But if you watch right to the end, Jonesy was there, large as life, and he was telling me the story about how, let's just say, you would have seen Jonesy being given the finger, so to speak. The horizontal finger, well, not the vertical finger.
Yeah. I'm a lovely person.
You're a lovely person, except I don't think she was saying that. Anyway, I was then just saying to Jonesy, I was in a video for a wonderful person on the Central Coast, Chelsea Berman.
Yeah.
Chelsea, the call went out. Call went out for, I guess, some people to be in a video.
Always looking for high-paid extras.
Well, I think it was more like if you've got black pants and a white shirt, can be in the video as a waiter.
You know what? What can you tell me about Chelsea? I don't know too much about her.
Chelsea's a local Central Coast girl, been performing since she was, I think, eight. You know, she's one of these people who starts off young. Is really hitting the straps now in 2019. I mean, she released the video that "Kiss Me Like You Miss Me," the one that I'm in, and yes, I get that cameo appearance of being a waiter. You know, you're there for 4 or 5 hours, and you end up being in the video for a microsecond.
Yes.
But with that song, she then went on to become one of the finalists for the Toyota.
Star Maker
2019.
Wow. Well, you don't get there unless you've got talent.
That's right. And she's released a few other songs after that. And we must see if we can have a chat to her. But also,
I'll have to check my catalogue of music in the main system. I'm sure we must have some of her songs here. If not, I'll make sure we can get them, and we'll get them on air for sure.
Yeah. Oh, and I mean, she's just, you're talking about musos. Chelsea, I would consider a friend. She's just an all-round nice person.
Yep.
Great singer. And, you know, it's one of those things, it's a small world. You go along to a social event. My partner, who is a teacher, taught Chelsea.
Wow.
And you just go... Central Coast of New South Wales is just a small
community.
Small community, yeah, where people know each other.
It is, and it's probably one of the most people have lived in Sydney. Can I say you've lived in Sydney
I was born in the country, moved to Sydney, then moved back up here.
Man, I was born in the country, moved to Sydney, and come back up here. How's that? See, we're
buddies,
we're brothers, mates. Brothers from different mothers. Yeah. Well, there you go. Well, that's interesting. What part of the country were you born?
Cowra.
Wow, Cowra. You'll have to come down to the storm cellar Cowra Festival, which is the Crabs Festival. It's an acronym.
So I'm thinking it's Cowra Roots and Blues as opposed to, you know, the Cowra Yabby Festival or something like that.
No, yeah, you hit it, mate. The Cowra Roots and Blues.
Oh, and when's that festival?
I think it's not December, so it must be the month before.
That'd be November, Jonesy. is that going to happen with COVID?
Well, I was talking to Michael about that, actually, because believe it or not,
perhaps we should tell people who Michael is. Oh, Michael, I know who Michael is.
Yeah, well, Michael is the creative genius from Storm Cellar. And, yeah, and just quietly, they've got 11 albums, music that gets played all around the world. And unless you're into the local music scene, you've never seen them, never heard of them.
Tell you what, I learnt to play the harmonica very, very poorly. Apparently I don't have the right way of playing a harmonica. I can't roll my tongue or that sort of thing properly to play the harmonica. But in that, I signed up, you put your name on a mailing list, and when great harmonica people were coming up to the Central Coast, and you know who used to appear there on a regular basis? Michael, because of his harmonica skills.
Yeah, he's one of
So he is just not only a great singer and a great person, but a great player.
Yeah, and what a character. Like, let me tell you, 5 weeks away living in rooms and...
living out of each other's pockets.
Oh, man, you learn a lot of things about a lot of people, let me tell you that. And he is a lovely guy, lovely guy. They couldn't get it. They won... To go to America, they won the Sydney Blues... The Sydney Blues Society Challenge. There's a big competition and all the blues bands play, and if you win, you get money from the Blues Society to go to the International Blues Challenge in Memphis.
I mean, with the size of the band, you'd need a fair bit of money.
Yeah, well, that's their downside. But anyway, they won the comp, so the reason I say that is that they're definitely a quality band, you know, like a quality blues band, but... Like, they play rock, they play folk, they play music scores. You know, they've done music scores. They've been in TV shows, in different TV productions.
I imagine they'd look good on stage if you're doing something like one of those crime dramas where the baddies are meeting in a hotel and they're playing in the background.
Yeah, well, they were on a one of them, what was that TV show where the... Oh, there's an American show. They've got a song called Black Crow, and in this TV show, Black Crows were flying down and attacking a car, and the producers have Googled, let's look for a song that says Black Crow.
Yeah.
And they got the Storm Cellar song Black Crow, which we won't play this week. I reckon we'll get that one on next week.
Yeah.
But, and they used probably 1 minute, 20 seconds of the song in the actual TV show, and they got a few sales out of that one too, I think. It's what they were saying. But
anyway, I forgot what we started. I mean, Cowra.
Cowra, yeah.
So I was born in Cowra.
Wow, well, being a quality band, they kept applying for blues festivals and kept getting knocked back. Couldn't get on for love or money. And all these other bands that go in these competitions get kicked out early. So it just sort of makes you think who's booking these festivals probably don't know what they're looking for. But in saying that, Michael goes, well, you know, I'm not going to beat them. I'm going to play their own game. So he rings around and organises a Tamworth Country Music Festival. He says, I'm going to start a smaller one in Cowra. And so he gets the local governments involved, gets a couple of grants. There's a market on during the day.
That's the way. If you sometimes, I guess completely out of left field, same thing. Five Lanes Walk here on the Central Coast. Perhaps we can talk about that in the future.
Oh, but for sure.
Yeah, it's sometimes that's the best way to get things happening. You just have an idea, find the funding, and
get it done.
Get it done.
And then after that one, he done the same thing with Kirribilli Council, and they organised the Crabs Festival under the Harbour Bridge at Sydney. So they had that, and not that long back, just before COVID, the weather was terrible and it was just unlucky weather-wise. But, yeah, I'm not sure if that one's going ahead, or I'm not sure if Cowra's going ahead with COVID. But Michael, Mr. Barry, he just said that they're going to give us the week out, the week before the event. Is yay or nay? So
okay,
they're happy. It's an outdoor festival, so they probably had, oh, say 300-400 people there last year, and everyone sort of walks around this big, you know, that, you know where the, you obviously know Cowra,
yeah,
you know the shell stage,
yeah,
the big seashell thing, yes. Which is why are seashells in Cowra?
Acoustics. I think it's probably acoustics, James.
Okay. Well, anyway, they've got this big, like, oyster shell on the roof of this outdoor stage in their park, and it's a lovely big stage, a good setup, good sound. The guy come up from the south coast, I think Bateman's Bay, one of the sound engineers, and it was quite a good 6 or 7 acts. Crowd got involved. It was at the funny stage, I think there was a total fire ban on, but at night it was freezing cold, and in
that's Cowra.
In the day it was bloody hot. So if that's on, I'll give you a yell. We can
sleep in the back of your bus.
Well, we can sort something out, I'm sure.
We could broadcast from there.
Well, that's the plan. That's what I'm saying. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
For sure. He wants me to be involved. We could actually introduce the acts. Go abroad. We could actually live stream the whole event.
Oh, that's going to be using up megabytes.
Gigabytes. No. Because we're actually, not visually. We can record the gig visually, but put that out at a later date.
Okay.
But we can live stream the audio to the Australian Radio Indy.
Oh. So there's work.
And this beautiful little desk we've got here, with
the lights and the flashing, all that sort of thing.
Four channels. We can have four people on. We can interview people on the phone. We've got access. We've got a line in. We've got Bluetooth in. We've got these sound effects, and this one.
We haven't had to use that one so far with my bad jokes. They've all been good.
That's right. I need to invite some other Patsy on, but so that's a thought from the future. But geez, Cowra, hey, like, I was born at Werris Creek up near
Tamworth,
up near the, yeah, and that's why I really got sick of the country music festival, because when you live there and you get invaded by how many thousands go there,
tens of thousands,
you really are sick of it as a local. Like, it's great for the town, money comes in. Even if you talk to musos about that festival, even though that festival isn't on this year, that's a big first time for how long?
Ever, long time, probably. Probably the first time it's been cancelled.
Yeah, so for people that don't know, the Tamworth Country Music Festival and the Golden Guitars and all that sort of is like the big razzmatazz of the country music scene in Australia.
In Australia.
But if you're an artist, man, just to play there is great. And if you don't get invited to play a main stage, it's so hard to know the connections to get a room. And if you do get a room, you could be playing at 2 a.m. in the morning, you could be playing at 11, you could be playing at 6 in the at night. But, yes, the fees involved, the behind-the-scenes stuff that the average punter doesn't know, Tamworth is just so hard for an artist. Like, we could do a whole
show. And that's where...
we could do a whole show on that.
Yeah, well, that's where I've seen a couple of people, once again, just use their own initiative and set their... and basically create events for themselves, invite their friends along, because everybody's there. So we could perhaps, talk about some of those events in the future.
Yeah, for sure. Where I've still got family and friends is Werris Creek up near Tamworth, and they're in the Liverpool Plains Shire Council. So they're not, the actual festival is run by the Tamworth City Council. So it's a government, local government funded event, and money does actually go back into the local government. So there's a little bit of that there. I've been asked, wasn't last year, it was the year before, to set up an independent music festival for Quirindi at Werris Creek. So at a separate time frame, obviously.
You're not giving too much away here, are you, Jonesy?
No, no, no. Look, if anyone wants to set it up, go for it. You know, like the more, the merrier, as me screen went blank on the old laptop, and I thought, oh, how long have we been chatting for? And it's been about that time. But, yeah, so anyway, that's where Michael's going to Cowra, hopefully November, hopefully around that time. It should be blues and country. Roots, if you want to call roots. I just call it country. In the way country's got...
It's got so many genres.
And it goes from one extreme to the other.
Yeah, and that's it. You sometimes, I mean, I got introduced, I think I talked briefly about Rock the South, and you have country acts start off and then it finishes. One of the, you know, the headliner is Kid Rock, and you just go, Kid Rock and country, and you know what?
Yeah, Southern Rock.
It just filled the whole... 60, 80, 100,000 people went off with Kid Rock.
Man, I would have loved it. I would have been one of them ones jumping on someone's shoulders and killing them and going, yeah.
Well, the annoying thing was we'd actually paid for reasonably good seats, but as the night went on, more and more people snuck in and jumped the fences. But they fixed that for the next day, which I think the headliner was maybe Kenny Chesney. They went and got some chicken wire, and that stopped people crawling through the fences.
Chicken wire is good for a number of things, stopping beer bottles getting thrown at you.
Yeah.
Yeah, all right. So where are we going musically in this little segment? Where were we going to go? Anywhere special?
Well, we might just wait and see if we can get... if we can't get Chelsea for this week, we might get Chelsea for next week.
Yeah, for sure. We'll get – I'll tell you what we'll do next week. I'll give you the opportunity to have a
I don't like homework.
No, no, no. You pick an artist, a local artist or an independent artist, and you've got 10 minutes to – I'll give you a time frame. You've got 10 minutes to talk about it, a couple of songs, and that's going to be the ding – it's going to be Dingo's.
You know what? That's the beauty
of the week.
Even better, I've got my iPad here and I just had it covered up with a piece of paper. So, as I said, I consider Chelsea a mate.
Yeah.
I've just got yes, of course. So, you know, we're going to finish this with Kiss Me Like You Miss Me.
So, we're putting the video on.
We're putting the video.
And we've got the official okay.
We've got yes, of course.
Well, so...
We'll finish up with... And a little bit about Kiss Me Like You Miss Me.
Yep.
Co-written with Troy Kemp. Great.
I love Troy, as you know.
We could do a whole show on Troy.
We can. We've got some great... I got some great video too, actually.
Oh.
He probably wouldn't want to see it, but...
But anyway, what about we finish this up? We'll finish it up with Chelsea Berman, and perhaps we'll come back and talk a little... Because we started talking about Chelsea.
we
ended up... Going to Cowra, and I haven't even got to Kiama, whereas the town after Kiama, Cowra. Anyway, here we go. What about we introduce Chelsea Berman, Kiss Me Like You Miss Me, a great song, and around in about the middle, check out the really good waiter.
The good-looking waiter.
That's me.
Are you wearing a penguin suit?
Oh, I've got the black pants and the white shirt.
Okay, well, let's keep a lookout for the dingo, and here it is.
Kiss Me Like You Miss Me with Chelsea Berman.
And that's a cut.
I got your picture hanging right by my bedside. First thing I see when I wake up, last before I sleep at night. Keep second guessing, you might be the one. So consumed, caught up in you, that I get nothing done. Can't seem to put my phone down, can't wait for you to come around. Counting down the days till I can say, boy, kiss me like you miss me like. Couldn't wait to be with me like. It's gonna be the last time for a while. to be with me like it's gonna be the last time for a while.
I'd like to tell you about a remarkable radio station.
Australian Radio.
How are you doing?
You have a remarkable mouth.
We have a remarkable radio station.
All the stuff you want to hear.
Australian Radio.
Keep it locked on all day.
Australian Radio.
Yeah, we're back.
Well,
I love that waiter. You definitely scrubbed up for the part, my friend.
Oh, yes, I know. But, yeah, great song by Chelsea Berman. And I'm sure that we'll have – well, I do know that Chelsea has released some more music. So we'll get Chelsea's music up here again. And, yeah, she's only a local girl. So
what part of the coast?
She was at Terrigal and she just moved. She's just moved to Tascot.
Okay, well, yep, local.
And, oh, well, I guess what I should say, if you're looking at that video, and because you said, I guess when we were looking at the video before, who's the guy? That's actually Chelsea and her real-life boyfriend. So it's not as if they got acting.
And so he did actually bring her flowers to say, sorry for playing on my phone, I really am not that sort of guy.
No, he's not. He's not.
Okay. Well, we're going to test this new desk that's Bluetoothing this phone, which I've actually what have I got? 83%, so I can actually get rid of this monstrosity. So I'll get rid of the old charger pack because before the dingo turned up, I got to stop saying the dingo. Look,
that's making me sound like royalty. The dingo. I'm just dingo.
Yeah, dingo.
We didn't even talk about my shirts.
Well, I did see it before. I thought, for going out in the garden, I thought you might have got attacked earlier on by the bugs.
No, we'll see. What happens is when I was at the music station, I'd go out to events. I guess you have to make
The phone was ringing. Hang on. I don't know if I rang that or was a mistake. Let me just... keep talking.
That is you wanted to make yourself I guess stand out.
Get one of those insects.
And so I went with I got a really good deal on some shirts. So these have got ants. So over the next couple of weeks, you will see my variety of shirts.
Okay.
Because I figure there's not much that is. I may as well start off. If I'm going to do something from the beginning, I may as well...
look like an ant.
Well, it's ants this week, but the...
Yeah, you know me.
The problem is that some people may not like...
Let me just adjust that again.
Some people may not like some of my shirts. So we will give... Well, we've got lots of ones with animals and insects and...
Mate, I just love your class and style, mate. You're all...
Spiders. the shirt.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, we'll just see...
It's dialing. Oh, it is.
We're getting a phone call? Oh, we are.
Do you want to give me 2 minutes so I can get dressed? I just jumped out the shower.
Get dressed.
That's live radio for you.
Yeah, we'll just... you're all right, mate. You call me back when you're ready.
I'll ring you back.
See you, bud.
Yep, I'll ring you back.
All right. There you go, live radio. We are live.
Well, there you go.
You should have
sent him a text, Jonesy.
I teed that up. I actually teed that up.
You did, but we've then been talking for getting on for.
Oh, geez.
Look at the time. Yeah. I'll be on overtime rate soon. We've been talking for so long.
I'm looking for a sponsor just so John can buy more shirts.
Oh, so that'd be good. And in fact, the other thing,
headwear.
If I haven't got an Australian Radio Indie hat, I'm happy to wear your band's hat.
Definitely. actually, we'll do a.
We could have a hat off.
We can do a band merch segment as well. So anyone out there wants to get their merch and get a little plug on, we're sure to. Let's see what happens here.
Have you dried yourself properly, Andy?
Hello.
Hello.
Are you there? We are live to air.
Live to air from the Clarence Valley in New South Wales.
Okay, so live to air, ladies and gentlemen, I've got Andy Leisk, or Andy Townsend Leisk. I don't know, which way are we going to describe you, my friend?
Well, the LT is for Leisk hyphen.
Okay.
Townsend. So just Andy LT will do, mate.
Andy LT, all right. So I've got Andy LT on the line. He is part of the station as well, but also he's got this fantastic band. They're called the Odd Collective ALT, or is it ALT's Odd Collective? I keep mixing that up.
It's the Odd Collective ALT, because somebody else already had something too similar in the US. So I had to flip it, and there was another Facebook page, so it just flipped around the other way.
Okay. I think next week we're going to get Jonesy to do his homework.
Yeah. What do you want me to do? Oh, yeah, so when I talk, I know.
He hasn't needed to do his homework because I've been his right hand for many years. He didn't need to know because I knew.
Well, that's always good. You know, I've always said that great minds think alike, especially when they sit together in maths tests.
Yes.
Hang on.
That's one of my standard lines.
Yeah, it's great minds think alike in maths tests, especially in maths tests.
Especially when they sit next to each other.
Well, very good. I'll have to remember that one. Andy's on the phone after we got...
sidetracked again.
That was the joke of the week.
Maybe.
Can we do a joke of the week?
We'll work on it for next week.
All right, for next week. How's life treating you on the north coast up there, my friend?
Well, today the sun's shining after 2 days of rain and bitterly cold off the river, but it's quite beautiful up here. The westerly sun's shining in, and I'm looking out at the cane fields, feeling all inspired for the next trip to the studio with Murray, 16-17 next month.
Wow, yeah, that's right. 16th and 17th of next month, you've got new music getting recorded at Rocking Horse, is it?
Yeah, Rocking Horse in Byron Bay with the imitable Murray Burns from Mysex and Twilight Productions.
Wow, yep. And, what we're going to do, we are going to play the tune that was recorded there last time we were there. Can you... give us a little bit of insight into, you're not telling me nothing I don't know already, but for our viewers and our listeners, we have Andy, Andy LT.
Just T will do.
Well, we'll go back to the basics. All right, I got T on the line, and luckily or fortunately enough for me, you invited me up while you were in there finishing that song off. So it was great to be up there while that song was getting fixed and polished.
Touched up,
and great up there seeing how Murray works, and a lot of lovely location. But so tell us how this album or concept of yours or the music that you're recording, how it's all come about, and especially the song we're going to play.
Well, it's the album's called The Songs That Made Tea. And, you know, that's a play on words, obviously, but T being me. And the covers that I'm doing on the album with the Odd Collective really mean something to me. And, like, as you know, myself and Bob Yates go back
for when I was a 15-year-old kid, handing out flyers for him at the Civic and Civic in Goulburn Street and Paddington RSL gigs and stuff.
Yeah, and Bobby Yates, for our overseas listeners, is?
Was the original manager of MySex when they moved over from New Zealand in 78.
Yeah.
And their first single was called But You Don't Care. And from the moment I heard that song, that band hooked me. I'd already met them, but the song hooked me. And while it was hooking me, I heard it without keyboards.
Yeah.
Without any of that 80s synth stuff going on. I heard it with two rumbling guitars and an acoustic in the back of it. And when it came time to actually record the songs that made tea, that just had to be one of the first songs that went on the record, because it's sort of the reconnect with MySex via the Shanghai Project in 2014. Yeah. And reconnecting with Bob back in 2006, I think it was, 06, was off doing production with the original Angels band, which was the Brewster Brothers,
yeah,
Buzz Bidstrup and Chris Bailey.
Yeah.
And we were doing a gig at the Yarramalong Valley, down the bottom of the Blue Mountains. You turn left at Blackheath and there's this beautiful rainforest and this valley. Mm. And the Angels went and played this ball, and John Brewster and myself hadn't seen Bob Yates in years. Me, a lot longer than John Brewster had. It was like a homecoming weekend for the both of us, and I sat and talked to Bob, and we'd actually spoken about getting MySex back together, and it sort of all came full circle when I asked Murray to produce some songs on the album. And I explained to him why the whys and wherefores and how much that particular song had meant to me in the career path. And, I end up being lighting guy for them during the last run of dates they did. So, it sort of comes full circle, and now I'm back in there.
Yeah.
Sort of full circle, but that song, there's some things I would have liked to have sung it better, but it is what it is.
I remember you're in there, and you said you've sung it, and then you've said let's do it again, and he's going, no, mate, you've nailed it. I'm happy with that. And you go, no, let's have another crack. And he said, no, I'm happy with what you've done. So if he's happy, mate, I'd be happy. I can tell you that.
Yeah, well, he's the man I was paying to do the job. And, well, again, we're going to tear the next one out is actually a driving song. And Murray's not going to let the cat out of the bag which song it actually is, but it inspires me to drive fast. And we're actually into the studio, as I said, on the 16th, 17th, sneaking the drummer and bass player out of Sydney to come up to the north, to come up to Byron Bay, as you have to in this day and age.
Hopefully, things might be really good in a few weeks' time.
Yeah.
Well, I'd like to think so, John, but the way things are going, I'd prefer the Mexicans and that actually stayed put.
Yes, we have trouble with the Mexicans, and we'll just leave that as a obscure reference that the Australians will understand.
Yes. but the Mexicans in the real Mexico, we love you guys.
Yeah.
We need more listeners. Well,
some of us call the Albury-Wodonga border the Mason-Dixon line.
Yes, and anything else you'd like to add about the song before we get to play it? Because we're just about coming to the end of the show, and we're going to finish it with this great film clip that we did.
Mate, it's weird, that song. It's been out now just over a year.
Yeah.
And I can't believe that the one country in the world that's actually hammered on purchasing But You Don't Care is the Philippines.
Wow.
And you and I both remember Philippines being the bootlegging capital of the world.
Yeah, that's right.
So it's quite spinny that you can actually sell more copies in something legitimately than you have in Australia. And, you know, I made 39 cents on Spotify. Jeez, that's a whole lot more than some of them big artists have made.
Yes, and it was just, the film clip too was a quick sort of version that we got out there. It wasn't really the polished product that we were hoping to get out, but still it's got some visuals and shows the band in the background live with a few shots of someone pointing to New Zealand or whatever it was. Was that shot too, wasn't it?
No, that's the hooded man looking at the coal loaders trying to get into Newcastle and thinking,
yeah,
they sold that bloody thing to China. And that's what I was thinking. I was the hooded man, obviously. That's what I was thinking. I'm thinking, you bastards do not care about the Hunter Valley. And having spent a good decade and a bit living in the Hunter Valley, I know it's going to fall into itself. And that's what that bit was all about. I'm standing at Redhead Bluff thinking, these bastards don't give a crap. And I was right. And it sort of fit with the "but you don't care."
Right. Well, in saying that, how would you like to introduce the song there, my friend? And we'll get the video on straight after the introduction.
Okay, I'm Andy from The Odd Collective, and this is The Odd Collective ALT's "But You Don't Care."
Thanks, Andy.
Cheers, guys.
Thanks, Andy. All righty then. So what I'll do, that's it. Up comes the song right now.
The lightning flash in the plate glass. Reflection spears a hole in the back of my eyes. Well, an old man saunters nearby, not noticing the flash from the chrome bars inside. I got you down on your bended knees. You beg for more treatment, please. Why can't you let it be a tree stump twist like blood-stained mist? But you don't care. You just don't care.
Australian Radio Indie. Streaming Australian music on the World Wide Web.
And that was But You Don't Care
by Andy.
Yeah, the Odd Collective ALT.
He's very good. That is, I love a man who's got passion.
Oh, yeah. He's got passion, right?
Passion about his music and about his songs. And I guess he's looking to do good things.
Yeah, and he's, you know, he's toured the world with Disney on Ice.
What was his role?
He was everything from lighting to driving the machine that makes the ice. What's that machine that does the laps?
That's called a...
Yeah, it was a specialised job, actually.
Yeah.
Yeah, you got to flood the water, then you got to do the... Anyway.
I lost something... I'll remember that as soon as we stop, because...
Well, anyway... Zimbizi or something.
Anyway, because Zambuga. No, it's not a Zambuga. And it's not Zambezi either.
Yeah.
But it was a
Zambezi. You know the dragon song? Chun 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 chun.
Jonesy, I think it's time to go.
It's that time of the day. All right. Yeah.
But we were talking, I mean, briefly touched on merchandise and we're joking about a hat. But in reality, if you see a band,
yeah,
that's, buy some of their merch, because you know what?
That's where
As Andy said, people listening on Spotify, you got a check for 39 cents. Buy a hat, buy an album.
That's for a quarter.
Yeah. Support your local artist. Doesn't matter where you are in the world, where you're listening to us.
Merch, merch is the best way.
Buy something, get them to sign it.
Hard copy.
And if you've already got one, you know what? Give it to a friend.
That's right. And hats, actually, where's that? I had a Troy Kemp hat. Where was that hat? Somewhere? Producer? Anyway, we're like a good old Troy Kemp. He'd do his local TK Martin show, which he just sort of sung covers and the occasional Troy Kemp song by himself as a soloist. But, we used to go support him. And, I'm a hat man, as you can tell, because of me good locks of blonde hair that I want to cover up.
I tell you, funny, I was up seeing my...
Hang on, we're getting ready to press a button.
No, this is... I was up seeing my grandson yesterday. And he looked at me.
How old?
He's 3 and a half.
Yep,
and true. He looks at me and says, "Poppy, what happened to your hair?" And then I explained to him, pointing at his dad, and I said, "Mate, you know, I got old and I lost my hair, and a bit like your dad is, and you will at some stage." "No, Poppy, I'm not going to lose my hair." Yeah, I know, it's a tragedy. I lost mine very early. Anyway, it's been hope you've enjoyed it, and thanks for sharing a part of your week with us.
Same time every week, we're going to come out weekly Sunday nights on digital radio, on Australian Radio Indie, from 6 p.m. Australian Eastern Standard Time. Or yeah, we'll just stick with that. If you're anywhere in the world, look up what time it is in Sydney and you'll get our time zones.
We should be I'll be prepared. So I'll have a list of time zones next week so we can simply say good morning to, let's say, Chicago.
Well, you know what, the good thing about putting this show now on YouTube is that you can watch it at your leisure.
You can watch it at your leisure.
So we'll upload it every Sunday at a certain time. It'll be uploaded to YouTube. You'll get some visuals, some film clips. You'll get to see how good-looking John's shirts are. He's got a lovely...
They will start to repeat at some point.
I got my Kmart shirt and my Walmart jacket.
Jonesy.
Yeah. And my Kmart trackies. Jeez, I'm multi-layering today.
And it's such a beautiful day. So I think
it is.
I think we should both sign off. Hope you've enjoyed the music. Let's go outside and probably work in the garden a little bit more before
it's spring. Yeah, we're going to get some warm weather this week. If you're listening in America, bad luck. Yous are getting winter, and we're getting the hot or the warm.
Oh, it's still warm. It's still warm in some parts of America at the moment. So,
well, yeah.
Stay safe.
Like and subscribe our YouTube channel. Support Australian Radio Indie TV, and support What's Happening Entertainment Radio, and What's Happening Entertainment on YouTube as well. You'll get to see them guys do a great show, Tony and Tim. And, we'll be doing a bit for them. They'll be doing a bit for us, and we'll check you out next week.
Okay, be kind to each other, take care, stay safe, and enjoy the music.
Peace and love.
Peace and love. That's Bye. It.